Good morning, everybody. Terry Green TV here. Here with a little video about something I came across in my readings, and it's kind of interesting, and kind of want to put it out there and see what other people think. So before we get started on that subject, the subject matter is going to be the thought and process of the Holy Grail. Most of us or people have believed forever that the Holy Grail was a physical item, the cup of Jesus at the Last Supper. But I want to take it to a different level and show a little proof of that, of what I'm talking about. So before we get into that, let's get started with a prayer for today. And if you like what we're doing, you can always hit the like and subscribe. You know, the more that we get the message out of the Lord Jesus Christ, the more that we can bring followers in. This channel is not about trying to make money or anything like that. Is about trying to help as many people as possible. So with that said, let's start with our prayer. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, I call upon you today to reach out and touch everybody for their needs as you hear their voices and you see their hearts. Those that are struggling with addiction, please reach out and put your loving hands around them and lead them to the light of Jesus Christ and to focus their life on things that are fruitful and what matters. Also, Lord, please put your hands around all those suffering from mental illnesses. We know at these days and times that this is a serious problem, that you put your loving hands around them and you get them the help that they need. And your Son, Jesus, walks alongside those as well. We also pray for all the homeless and the hungry out there. Lord, you know what their needs are, and you provide them shelter and food. We also pray for all the sick, all the ones that are still dealing with COVID, that you put your loving hands around them and bring them back over from the shadow of death and bring them back to life and show them that the miracles are possible through your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray for all those who are suffering and grieving from losses. We also pray for all those who are dealing with stress. We understand that these days and times, there's a lot of stress upon our lives and our families and our children, and you just put your loving hands around them. We also pray for our nation, Lord. We know there's a lot of strife and division, and the focus, we see it every day. The focus has lost, this country has lost its focus on your Son, Jesus Christ, in so many ways. And you, Lord, alone understand that through Jesus and through your word, that we all can be one and we all can be one great nation. I ask for all these things, Lord, and hopefully that people that hear this message, they find peace in their day. With Jesus' name, amen. So, you know, I've been reading my daily Bible. Again, start with Proverbs, which Proverbs actually 16 and 17 have been really good last few days, especially for me, things I'm working on. So they've been really good. But you know, I've also been doing Read the Bible in a Year plan, and that's been going well. Deuteronomy is super deep. And then of course we read Revelations every day, and that's something we're gonna have to take time to touch on, the book of Revelations, because that is so deep. I mean, that just takes time to break down. So we'll eventually get to that. But I specifically want to talk about the Holy Grail and some thoughts that I had about it, reading about it. So I think a lot of times people take the Bible and look at it from a straightforward approach instead of taking it and looking at it deeper. And this is an example of that. We're going to look specifically at John. John has a lot of ways you can look at John. You can look at it from a straightforward approach, which I think looking at it in any approach is good, but looking at it from a straightforward approach instead of trying to really break it down, you kind of lose some things and you kind of lose some context about what's being said, because I believe John was very deep. His book is very deep. So I really want to talk about what is the Holy Grail. So here's what I believe. I believe the Holy Grail is us. So we've been searching for this forever, and really the Holy Grail is us. And what God wants and what Jesus wants in us. And what I mean by that is just the one of Jesus's miracles that was transcribed in John, which I believe it was his very first miracle, was at a Jewish wedding banquet when they ran out of wine. Now, Some people will say, well, you know, drinking is a sin, and actually it's not. The Bible uses references to wine 250 times in the Bible. What it says is a sin is becoming a drunkard. Now, it was practiced back then because water quality was so bad that wine was safer to drink. So actually, they would drink wine with almost every meal. But once you overstep the boundaries of just drinking wine as this healthy, fruitful thing for your body, because there are some scientific beliefs that wine actually helps thin your blood, so it reduces blood clots and things like that. So, you know, back then it was more about sanitary. The water quality was poor, so they drank wine. But once you overstep the boundaries and become a drunkard, then that's when everything that happens to that point and after that point becomes a sin. So let's be clear on that. So what I want to talk about is in John, his first miracle was changing water into wine. And he done so, and I think we've talked about this in other videos, about having faith and belief. So when he called the servants and they said, and Mary actually said, go with him and do what he says, which is Jesus' mother, and they did as Jesus said, and they believed in what Jesus told them to do. He actually was able to change six stone jars of water into wine. And let me explain to you why I believe that we are the Holy Grail. And this is what I'm going to read to you. This is John 2, 7 through 10. It says, Jesus said to the servants, fill the jars with water, and they filled them to the brim. And that's a key point. They filled them to the brim. He didn't tell them to fill them to the brim or halfway. He said, fill the jars, and they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, now draw some from them and take it to the head waiter. And they did. The head waiter tasted the water that had become wine. He didn't know where it came from through the servant who drew the water, but he didn't know where they came from, but the servants who drew the water knew. The head waiter called the groom and said, everyone serves the good wine first. They bring out the second-rate wine only when the guests are drinking freely. You keep the good wine until now. So that is John 2, 7 through 10. And so what the servants just didn't fill up the jars, they filled it to the brim. And I think if you look at that at a deeper meaning, what that means is John telling us that Jesus makes us complete. Jesus fills us up completely. In fact, he fills us up so much once we follow Christ, it's like it runs over. And so, you know, when you really look at that in the context of walking with Jesus, believing in Jesus, how he fills you to the brim, he fills you until you're, let's just say you're in a metaphorical term, your cup is runneth over. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, a way to look at it and say, you know what? We're not looking for a physical thing. We are the Holy Grail. We are the ones that God, you know, loves and chose. And we are the ones that Jesus Christ, through his sacrifices and through his works, completes us. So just food for thought to think about that Jesus, following Jesus and loving Jesus and just staying focused on Jesus fills you completely. And we'll talk further about a lot of things I'm learning as I read the Bible about how to live your life and how you're what I think people get things construed about blessings and comparable to miracles when they ask for things and things like that. And that's something, again, we'll get deeper into. But I just wanted to put that nugget out there that is the Holy Grail not a physical thing, but are we the Holy Grail? Are we the bloodlines and the followers and the believers of God and Jesus Christ? And are we the coveted ones? I believe so. And I believe that as long as we follow and keep our focus on Christ and pay attention, you know, our lives will be filled to the brim. We'll be complete. I think that's what John was talking about in John 2, 7 through 10. So anyway, hit subscribe, hit the like, always comment if you want to, you know, chime in on it and what your thoughts are. But this is what I'm getting as I like to break things down deeper and try to get the deeper the deeper side of things. So how do I apply that in my everyday living? And if people ask, how, you know, I can give them some of my theories and reasons. So like I said, I'm always open to interpretations and suggestions, but that's just my thought on the Holy Grail, that we are the people, the brothers and sisters of Christ, and the sons and daughters of God are the Holy Grail. And we were chosen that way because God loved us so much. So with that said, everybody have a great and blessed day.